Guys, today we are discussing about a very important topic. This is the sequence of tooth eruption. As we all know guys, the humans contain two type of dentition. The first is deciduous dentition and second one is permanent dentition. The deciduous dentition is that dentition which appear in the children's only. The firstly erupted teeth is the lower central incisor. This erupted in the 6 month of age group. And the permanent dentition is which type of dentition which seen in adults. The primary dentition or deciduous dentition contains central incisor, lateral incisor and canine and molars. And the permanent dentition contains incisors, lateral incisor, premolars and molar. Actually guys, people have some confusion for remembering this, which type of dentition contain premolar or which type dentition not contain premolar. Guys, P refers to permanent and P refers to premolar. So permanent dentition contain premolar. As we all know guys, our oral cavity divided into the four quadrants. The upper two quadrant maxillary arch and lower two quadrant is the mandibular arch. This is the sequence of deciduous tooth eruption. Guys, this is very typical to remember. So I will teach you in a very simple method or very simple mnemonics. So let's see what it is. Sequence of deciduous tooth eruption. As I described, lower teeth appear first. Our first erupted teeth is the lower central incisor. This is the central incisor is erupted on the 6 month of age group. Lateral incisor erupt on the 10 month of age group. Canine erupt on the 17 to 23 month of age group. First molar erupt on the 14 year of age group. And second molar erupt on the 23 month of age group. So guys, you can remember these 5 by a very simple trick. This is the successful teachers save time for teaching. Guys, central incisor S refers to 6 and so central incisor erupt on the 6 month of age group. And this lateral incisor T, the T start teacher, T refers to 10. So lateral incisor will erupt on the 10 month of age group. And this just after it write 10 here. 10 and I write this 7. Save. So S refers to 7. 10 plus 7 is equal to 17. So canine will erupt on the 17 month of age group. And the first molar, this right here 10 again, and this time is useless. What is it? 4. 4. So F refers to 4. So write 4 here. 10 plus 4 is equal to 14 month of age group. And for second molar, T teaching. T refers to 23. So you can remember by this very simple mnemonics. Successful teacher save time for teaching. S for 6. Central incisor. T refers to 10, lateral incisor 10 months, and write 10 here and save 7. 10 plus 7 is equal to 17 for canine, and the for first molar, write 10 here and F refers to 4. 10 plus 4 is equal to 14, and this second molar teaching T refers to 33. Now, guys, for upper teeth central incisor erupt on the 8 month of age group, lateral incisor 9 month of age group. Canine 16 month of age group, first molar 13 month of age group, second molar 25 month of age group. Guys, for central incisor, just write eruption here. E-R-U-P-T-I-O-N. This is the 4 letter word. E-R-U-P-T-I-O-N. 4 and 4. 8 letter word. So, central incisor will erupt on the 8th month of age group. And just, this is very simple to remembering, just minus 1 from previous dentition. It's mean to say lower teeth. Lateral incisor 10, if we minus 1, this is 9 month. So lateral incisor of 14 will appear on the 9th month of age group. And for canine, this is 17 for lower tooth, just minus again 1. This is the 16th month of age group. For first molar, again minus 1, this is the 13 year of age group. And for second molar, you can write this teacher again, teacher. This refers to 25 month of age group. So thank you guys. If you like my video, please like, subscribe and share. Thank you guys. In my next video, I will discuss about the sequence of permanent dentition. Please remember this. This is very important for exam point of view, university exams. your periodontics point of view for NEET PG competitive exam. Thank you guys. Thank you so much.